Hey everyone, welcome back to the Neo Marketing Podcast. On today's episode, we're going to talk about brand communication during crisis. Welcome to the weekly Neo Marketing Podcast, featuring one half of the Golden Group C-Suite, Kyle Golding, and Pritch Pritchard, APR, PRSA Fellow. Okay, Pritch, I got a question for you. You are the PR pro, the PR expert, the master. There's a lot going on in the world right now.
True that.
There's a lot of crisis going on. There's weather, there's shooters, there's crime, there's politics. What is the thought process? What is the internal process? What happens for a brand during crisis as far as their communication with their audience, their employees, with the community?
You take all of that together and you have to, and I'm glad you mentioned employees because you've got to consider employees. They're your ambassadors. They're talking over the back fence. They need to know what your organization is saying. But the organization doesn't always have to say something.
True.
If it's not relevant to them, I mean, unless you've got an interest in Las Vegas, for example, the Mandalay Hotel, certainly.
For sure.
Should have had something. The police, of course, are the ones, the sheriff's department's leading the investigation. They're giving you details on that side of the equation. That's certainly appropriate. I-91, the organizers of the festival,
right,
2 days before they made a comment. So I think there was some wrangling with the lawyers in the boardroom over whether or not we're going to say anything. And then when they did say something, it wasn't necessarily appropriate in my mind.
Two days is definitely a long time.
Too long.
You know, 2 minutes, maybe an hour is probably too fast. You know, there was a lot of chaos happening on the ground,
unfortunately,
for what happened in Las Vegas. But at some point in that process, they do need to start a communication channel, right? They
absolutely
need to be part of the process.
Absolutely, if it's appropriate. And I think, but I think you have to have that discussion in the C-suite, and the lawyer should be part of that as well. But is it appropriate for us to say something? If Oreos came out now and said, you know, we regret, this is a terrible travesty, and you know, our cookies bring comfort to people, and we hope that
well, then that'd
helps
be more like tragedy hijacking.
Absolutely,
there, right?
That'd be self-appropriate
pandering.
Absolutely.
So that's the other side of the equation, right? Is,
yep,
it's obviously there are people who need to make comments, like you said, people who are associated with Las Vegas in that case, or associated with Texas in the, or Puerto Rico. But then people who are not associated, who try to glom on to the public sentiment, sort of get their name front and center, that's a bad idea as well, right?
Yeah, I think it's a lot like looky-loos on the highway when there's an accident. I mean, what are you going to do to help the situation? Drive on. Don't create another accident waiting to happen.
My personal take on it, for the brands that we manage, is in a situation that's sensitive, whether it's a tragedy that has been as bad as the last week or two, or something that's just maybe controversial, I always err on the side of not before I do.
Absolutely.
When it doesn't directly affect us or the specific industry that we're in very directly.
Sure, absolutely.
And when in doubt, say nothing, right?
When in doubt, don't do anything.
But when all eyes are looking at you, such as the hotel, such as the concert organizer, yeah, such as maybe a mayor of a city in Puerto Rico,
right?
You do have
the
to
governor.
You
right.
do have to be very specific in your communication goals.
Absolutely.
To have the crisis managed to help people, and then B, to inform people as to what has happened and what the recovery efforts, et cetera, et cetera,
right,
and how other people can help,
and how you're going to try and prevent this from happening again. That's a key.
Exactly.
Part of that statement.
So in both cases, whether you're directly involved and you're swept up in the crisis, or you're on the outside looking in trying to decide if you should make a statement in support or pro or con, the key is being prepared before it happens.
Absolutely.
Right? So
absolutely,
you have to have conversations with your internally, you know, again, back to the C-suite, the leadership, and have conversations with everyone in your organization, obviously your communication team, about what you do represent, what you don't represent. And when in doubt, slow down.
Slow down. And it loops back to what we said in a previous podcast, and that is protocol.
Right.
If you've got the protocol, you can have that conversation pretty quick.
The Golden Group Conversations videos, you guys go look it up on YouTube. We did have a whole conversation about communication protocols versus writing it down, putting it in a binder, and putting it on your shelf, right?
Letting it collect dust.
So our bonus question today is going to follow up right with the same conversation, which is people, there have been some missteps over the last week in crisis communication. What crisis communication misstep, bonehead move would you like to call out?
I'm going to give a bonehead award to the organizers of the I-91 Harvest Concert. They were late in their response. They should have been right there front and center. Condolences is fine, but then they really hamburgered up their statement. It was emotional. They used the word souls twice in that statement.
Just not a very AP style.
Not at all. And it has a connotation that maybe doesn't resonate with everybody.
Gotcha.
So
I understand, right?
And lots of capitals, lots of words capitalized in the release.
Oh, so they were yelling at us?
They were yelling at us, yeah, absolutely. So the bonehead award for this week goes to the I-91 concert organizers.
We obviously, we're human beings, so we're sympathetic to what happened at the concert with the mass shooting. But the professionals in charge, first, the police have to do their job, first responders, which we all agree did a magnificent job.
Absolutely.
With that. But once the scene is secure, and once people are getting medical attention and the police are doing their job, the professionals involved, the people who put on the show and are surrounded by it, have to be professionals and communicate,
yes.
Right?
Yes.
And so their failure is in communication, not in the show itself. And
no, course, that's exactly right.
The blame on
anybody's
the actions
response.
Or the shooter
right.
himself.
Right.
No one could have predicted this activity, but you could. I don't want to say you make it worse because it's tragic. More than 50 people have lost their lives, but the situation was definitely not bettered in any way or streamlined or helpful in the communication where people were trying to concern about people that were involved, the musicians, the crew, the people
right.
who worked at the hotel,
right.
Loved ones in the area, other businesses, etc., when communication is poor.
The communication was all self-serving. It was all about
I-91. Oh.
Sympathy for the victims, certainly, and the families and whatnot, but it was all about them. We will keep going. We won't let this stop us. And,
That definitely needed to come later.
It definitely needed to come later.
Yeah, the focus needed to be.
What are we doing now to help those people that were affected?
I agree with you on that. I like that, your approach. I agree with you 100%.
Awesome.
If I had to give a bonehead award, another tragedy in a certain way, we lost Tom Petty. The rock star Tom Petty died this week. And unfortunately,
great loss.
There was a lot of confusion about him being found unconscious. It was a cardiac event, being taken to the hospital. Apparently, the hospital released an official statement saying he had died and then had to come back out hours later and to clarify that he had not died. He was still with us.
Yep.
He did eventually die, but the timing was wrong. And it was a rush, whether it was a rush to make the statement first or to please press or whatever the thought process was.
Definitely
a
bonehead award.
The people at the hospital did not take their time
right.
and be thorough in, probably even weren't even thorough in their interactions with the family.
Not at all. I can't imagine
quick.
That they would.
Right. So, folks, slow down. Take your time and do this right. Communication's key. You know, we're all like in the
Absolutely.
Age of 7 seconds and get it to me and I'll read it on Twitter the minute it happens. But that doesn't mean that you give professionals excuses to make these bonehead moves, because we're all professionals in this scenario. You know, individuals to do stuff on Twitter or on social media in general, that's fine. If you're a professional and you're really bad at this, you need to maybe rethink that job.
Two words, slow down.
Get it right. We're going to end it on that, folks. I promise you, next week's episode will be a little bit more upbeat, but occasionally we just got to jump in, talk about what's happening in the world, and use real-world examples to help you guys get better at what you do and have this thought process in case you ever need it in your professional life. So we hope that was helpful. Until next time, good luck.
Ciao.